Welcome to Voyager, Elkar's menu system.
That's a little on the cringe side. Okay, let's see if I can do something about this. If I can got any higher resolution than this. What's my... Yeah, that's about as high as that's going to go. I can hand edit the INI file, but... Or the CF configuration file, but... Yeah, I don't know if that's going to work out too well. Okay, let's see here. Then I guess we'll just get into it. We're not going to bother with the tutorial. We're just going to get into it. Well, anyway, guys, welcome to Star Trek Voyager Elite Force. Let's see here. Just real quick, I'm going to do the comment. I forgot to actually do that. Concentrating on getting this fucker to run.
On Stardate 48315.6, the USS Voyager was transported beyond our control, 70,000 light-years across the galaxy to the Delta Quadrant. There, without aid from Starfleet, we began our 70-year journey home. In our numerous encounters, we came into contact with many dangerous and violent species. Having a limited crew with no chance of reinforcements, we determined that we needed a specialized team to handle the more dangerous situations. Tuvok, Voyager's chief of security, assembled an elite force of security personnel named the Hazard Team. Ensign Monroe is second in command of this uniquely trained team. Equipped with 7 of 9's experimental anti-Borg weapon, the Infinity Modulator, the Hazard Team has beamed to a Borg cube on a dangerous mission. However, the team was quickly overwhelmed, and the I-Mod is now in the hands of the Borg. Separated from the rest, Monroe is attempting to rescue the team.
The old Wake 3 engine. So fucking stilted looking.
Monroe and Tuvok. Off from the rest of the Hazard Team. I don't know where they are.
Mr. Monroe, we have isolated your team members' life signs. They appear to be trapped in the tertiary power modulation chamber. Rescue them at any cost.
Acknowledged. Tertiary what?
Okay, real quick, I'm gonna do this. Let's see, good form on the jump. Some guy leaves a comment for the finale of Sticks. Good form on the jump, botched landing, 6 out of 10. Yeah, it happens. Like I said before, the jumping in Sticks is kind of special. I'm sensing a repeating pattern. It wasn't that much of a pattern. I mean, it happened a couple of times, but no big deal. Miracle of miracles, you did it. Not sure I want to know how long it actually took. Really didn't take that long. The thing was, I was stressing out because I was trying to get this shit done on camera. It's kind of hard to get through that part. Because as you can see, the rest of it was... almost totally a breeze to get through. It was pretty fucking easy, but that first part where you have to get that golem and knock down that bridge, that thing's a bitch. But anyway, thanks for your comments, some guy, and on with the show. Let's see here. Got us tonight.
Ensign, I've uploaded your mission objectives and tactical information.
I like shooting Borg. Anyhow, my train of thought completely fucking derailed. Gotta love that. Alright, we need to find a power thingamajigger. Power thingamajigger, where you at? Or another route. Because that's not gonna work. There we go. Okay, that's a weapon recharger. Now Don't know why the Borg would have a weapon recharger compatible with our hazard suits on board, but whatever. Well, according to the tutorial, basically it says something like it's set up to be compatible with alien power sources or some such. Basically, it's hand-wavium saying, okay, yeah, you can recharge your guns on board the Borg ships and whatnot. Yeah, the Borg can and will come to life on you at times. This will not be the only time we have to deal with the Borg. And of course, in Elite Force 2, there's collectibles, so you have to basically explore fucking everywhere. Okay, so this puts the... here. That poor sap gets trapped underneath this thing. Brutally murdered. One thing I will give them credit for is they got most of the original voice actors to reprise their parts in Voyager, of course.
Monroe! My savior! Put the iron on. It's on the table. Monroe, let's go.
Okay, the iMod is basically supposed to be a weapon developed by 7 of 9 that essentially infinitely modulates its weapon pulse so it can, you know, never be resisted by the Borg or some shit like that. Yeah, there is a team AI, such as it is. Hi! I don't want you coming up my ass when I'm going over here.
Thanks, Monroe. I'll get Odell back to the ship.
Okay. But anyway, it's basically a weapon, if I recall correctly, it's been developed only for the Elite Force games. I don't think anything like this quite showed up in Voyager. Then again, it's been a long time since I've really rewatched and paid attention to Voyager. Because while there were some good episodes in Voyager, it was kind of a pile.
Hey, blue force field? I don't see a dis note here. Must have a special power source. I'd come with you if I had an iMod, but what say I stay here at Hope Town?
Yeah, for stuff that you that doesn't require a special weapon to open. Yeah, shut the fuck up, dude. For stuff that requires does not require a special weapon, you might as well use your hand phaser to open it because it recharges itself. Okay, that's what I locked onto. Okay. Somebody just got the shit assimilated out of themselves. I wish auto run was a toggleable thing. I don't think it is, but. Actually, is it? Okay, wow, this setup is on subtitles. Yeah. I don't see it as a, Oh, always run is on, or is a toggleable, good. I want to be able to run, damn it. that force field should be right here. Yes, I know I've got a secondary fire on this thing. I don't really care. And you can, of course, turn everything into a sniper rifle if you really want to. Oh, yeah, that's right. I gotta ride this thing down. That really felt like that was going to be a plunge to the death, honestly. Well, that kind of screwed the pooch there. Okay, whatever. Not planning to. Actually, this is weapon energy and not health like I really want. That's how that shit's supposed to work. Oh, fuck me. Keep your eyes open, fucker. Don't get complacent. Some of these people should look familiar to you if you saw the episode of Voyager where They had a bunch of flunkies who were pretty much screw-ups, and Tuvok decided to train them, to make them decent Starfleet officers. These are those people, basically.
Hey, be careful.
I like this guy's attitude.
It's not working. I don't have time for this.
He's stupid, but he's my kind of stupid.
No way, the dog!
I told you. Well, what was I supposed to do?
Mr. Monroe, your tactical approach was, shall we say, tactless.
Har har, he made it funny.
All right, Hazard Team, report to debriefing.
Nice going, Monroe.
Sir, if I may. Wasn't he supposed to know the panel would explode?
That point is not relevant, Mr. Monroe. A given situation is not as predictable as you might desire. Your reckless decision has caused the death of you and your teammates. You have failed. Had you followed standard Hazard Team procedures, you may have survived the simulation and achieved your mission objectives.
Yes, sir. Procedure.
Speak freely.
Fuck your procedure, Tuvok.
Deck 4.
With all due respect, sir, I don't think procedure would have mattered. There wasn't any way I could have possibly rescued them.
Someday, Mr. Monroe, you may be called upon to do the impossible. Consider this to be your personal Kobayashi Maru.
Red alert. All hands to battle stations.
Yep, here's where shit gets real.
Computer, reroute turbo lift to the bridge.
Systems and disable them.
Firing phasers. Direct hit. Phasers had no discernible effect. Half shields are down, Captain. Rerouting auxiliary power to the shields.
Captain, I'm getting reports of extensive damage on decks 9 and 10. We're not going to survive another hit.
Photon torpedoes, full spread.
Torpedoes away.
Not what you would call a good sign.
Everyone all right?
I am undamaged.
What just happened?
Captain, we seem to have been torn from normal space. I think we've been pulled through some sort of isodimensional rift.
Where are we?
Apparently, here, Captain. Sensors and most of Voyager's primary systems are offline. Until repairs are made, it may be difficult to ascertain exactly where here is.
And yep, that was the teaser. They set this up like an episode of Voyager, basically. Excuse me.
Captain's log, stardate 53854.7. Voyager was attacked by an unknown force and transported to some kind of starship graveyard, whereabouts unknown. The ship is heavily damaged. Communications, propulsion, and other systems are offline. Until repairs are done, we're utterly helpless. Stranded. Let's get this ship back together, Chakotay. Get damage control online. Harry, find out what you can about those other ships, and exactly where we are.
Hi, Captain.
Captain, there's a containment leak in engineering. If we can't get it sealed, we're going to have a warp core breach.
Ensign Monroe, you're wearing a hazard suit. Get down to engineering and help Alana seal that leak.
Hey.
Dismissed.
Captain, we're drifting. Attempting to compensate with maneuvering thrusters.
I gotta fuck with the bridge crew.
Tom.
Sorry, Monroe. You'll have to take a range.
I'm having a hard time getting any sensor information on those derelict ships, Captain.
Keep trying, Ensign.
Tuvok.
And see if communications are back online.
Seven.
If you're here to fraternize, I do not have the time.
Seven.
If you're here to fraternize, I do not
Ensign
have
Monroe,
the time.
I Crewman. Believe the captain ordered Can't you see you I'm to working? Go to engineering.
Harry.
I'll see you later at rehearsal.
Okay, well, anyway. No, wrong room.
Captain, I have some data on one of the closer ships. It does not appear to have any life signs.
Scan for power sources. See if you can locate a
controlling
vessel.
Okay, well, this is the captain's fucking crib. Okay, so that's gotta be the turbolift.
Turbolift controls malfunctioning. Initiate vocal command using manual interface.
Deck 11, engineering.
Easy. This is a good sign.
Sir, here's the damage control progress for the aft side of the deck.
Good. Who's fixing the data shunt here?
Showers and Chell, sir.
Good. And Renner's on the Jeffries tubes.
Fucking toolboxes and shit left laying around.
Can you give me a hand with this plasma relay?
Excuse me.
Yeah?
That's totally worthless. You can be a complete ass and hit the panel before he gets through, and he'll die.
Close. Where were you heading?
I need
can
to take
I
a turbo
you?
Lift to engineering.
Well, the aft turbo lifts were the only ones working on this deck, but they're behind the containment field.
That was so fucking useful. Luckily, or not. Yep, you get to crawl through Jeffrey's tube on occasion. And now, we get to do the most dangerous foe of all, man. We get to go down ladders. Yeah, ladders are not the fucking best thing ever in this game, or, well, hell, for that matter, any game.
Hey, Monroe. Looks like the explosion took out these two aft turbolifts. Jeffrey's tubes are the only way down now. I was trying to clear the debris from this one when the EPS conduit's overloaded.
Great.
Well, the starboard side should be fine, but this one's gonna take me all day to fix now. Almost out of clear, too.
Yeah, we're gonna save, because this is a bitch. Obviously, though, is there a ladder? Yeah, there's like no way to get past that, I don't think. Or maybe jumping over it, I don't remember. I just barely got this fucking thing running, so if you're expecting absolute gee-whiz gameplay, then your expectations should probably be
lower. Sorry, Monroe. The data shunt's been severed here. Everything down this way is shut off.
Hey, we're getting a power surge here.
Monroe, quick! Hit that panel and shut off this relay.
That was close.
Okay. All right, well, here we go. No, climb down. Okay. this having
warning.
The
hazardous material detected.
This having the add-on, because this came with didn't come with, god damn it, this edition came with the add-on to this. The add-on basically replaces the voice actress who did Seven's voice with the actual Jerry Ryan, and it adds a ability to actually take a tour on Voyager. You can go walking through the ship, at least sort of. Okay, climb. Yes. Yep, drain away all the noxious and horrific chemicals, because, you know. That's a turbo lift there. That's a great sign.
Monroe, what took you so long? We've got a warp core breach in progress. You need to get in there and shut it down. There are two things you have to do, so listen carefully. First, cut the power relays on the main floor, then go to the upper level and decouple the dilithium matrix. Wait a minute. You're going to need a helmet to get through that coolant leak.
I've got one in my transporter buffer.
Oh yeah, that's another thing. That's how they explain.
Hurry up and find those terminals. There isn't much time before we lose containment and have to reject the core.
That's how they explain how you can carry all this shit. You have a...
Hurry, Monroe. I'm not sure how much time you've got left.
Okay,
attention. Let's... Warp core breach imminent.
Okay, she said...
Displaying power relay access code.
Got it.
Push the button. So I was going to say, there's a transporter relay, or transporter buffer on you.
Power relays must be cut in order to decouple
the dilithium.
Well, where the
fuck are the power relays?
Access granted. Power relays have been cut. Attention. Warp core breach in 30 seconds. Dilithium matrix decoupled. Warp core offline. Core breach averted.
Anyway, you have a mini transporter that stores all your shit, is what I was trying to say.
Good job, Ensign. That was touch and go there for a little while.
No problem, Lieutenant.
Okay, let's get a cleanup crew in here.
The shadows are so fucked up in this.
Get main power back online. Vorik, give me a hand with the resonance cascade modulator.
This complete douche nozzle.
Crewman. Sorry, no time to talk. Hey.
Sorry, don't have time for chit-chat.
Excuse me.
Can I help you?
Crewman.
Sorry, I'm kind of busy here. Gina, watch your alignment. That isodyne array has to be modulated to exactly 4.7 microjoules.
Torres.
Yes, ma'am. Look, Ensign, I'm kind of busy here.
Okay, well, you fuck you too.
Intruder alert! All security and hazard team personnel
Ensign
to the loading dock.
Is the coupling matrix back online yet?
Okay, so where's the fucking turbo lift? Thought that was one, like, right there. There it is.
How's it look, Justin?
Decade, not good. Loading dock.
The whole intermix matrix is out of whack.
Engineering to bridge.
All right, well, I'm going to get through this little section and then...
Here, Monroe, take this. Come on.
Gee, thanks for the fucking
if
loadout.
If you need medical attention, just come back here.
Monroe, over here. We're being invaded by some kind of pirates. They're taking our supplies. We have to stop them. There are two of them behind a barricade in there. They're launching energy grenades. See if you can eliminate them. Ready?
That's a Starfleet way, man. But putting it on stun, we're just going to murder these fucking... God damn it, jump over. There. Hey, fucker. Shouldn't we be able to depressurize the whole fucking deck? Okay, I guess I have to murder these fuckers. Held it. Let's go over here. How many of these fuckers are there gonna be, man? Come on. Okay, I need to get help. Fix me up, fuck Jason.
Come on. You'll be fine.
Oh wait, Hirogen. Now dead Hirogen.
I'll go check it out.
Okay, here's some button I'm supposed to be pressing. Like, what am I supposed to do? Okay, I'm here.
Tuvok to Foster. We're pinned down in Cargo Bay 1. We require your immediate assistance.
Monroe, Tuvok needs help. Come with me.
Actually, fuck you. I'm gonna go get healed. Hey, where the fuck did the doctor go? There he is. There we go. Thanks, Doc. Nope. Not very much of that. Alright, did you break? Did I just fucking break your script? Alright, load all the way up. Hope not. I fucking might have just broke him. Let me talk to him, see if that'll get him moving.
Sir, now is not the time, Ensign.
Okay, how about you start moving, because now is definitely the time for that. I think I fucking broke him. Fucking wow. Wait, what am I? Okay.
Hold your fire!
Okay, are we going this way? Where are we going? That's the turbo lift it came out of. Holy shit. That's honestly kind of hilarious.
Telsia.
Yes, Alex?
Sir.
Later, Ensign.
Yeah, I don't remember that. This breaking so easily, that's just fucking, well, it's hilarious, but, you know. Okay, am I missing something else? Follow Foster to Cargo Bay 2, yeah, okay. Okay, well, anyway, guys, I guess that's it for today. I'm gonna have to play back through this and get up to this point, you know, follow him. Or actually, you know what, we're just gonna make a fucking cut and then redo this and resume, because I do want to save after this fucking situation is over with. So I'll be back in a few minutes. That was it. Come on, bull. Yeah, at the end of this situation, I'm gonna save it. Yeah, you gotta have him push the fucking button. Just in case any more breakage happens. no more breakage. It only took like a minute to get back to where I was. But, all right, I'm
They're on the run. We did it.
To bridge. The intruders have been repelled.
Well done. It seems our situation is worse than we thought, Tuvok. Report to the conference room.
Acknowledged. Lieutenant Foster, have the team report to hazard operations. I am certain that many of you are curious as to our situation. Voyager has been transported to a region of space we are not familiar with. It seems that many other disabled vessels are present here as well. We have detected an energy dampening field surrounding the area that is draining Voyager systems of power. For the moment, we are trapped like the other ships and cannot escape.
Like the Tarkanis gravity well, 247 ships have been lost there.
Or the Bermuda Triangle. You know, back on Earth.
Perhaps. Our primary weapons and propulsion systems are offline at the moment. The captain's current strategy is to find out as much as we can about our surroundings while we effect repairs.
So, what's the deal with our unwelcome visitors?
We do not have much information about them as of yet, Mr. Beesman. They appear to be scavengers of some sort, comprised of Klingons, humans, and Malons. With only short-range sensors operational, we have been unable to locate their vessel since it departed. However, we have detected a vessel nearby. While sensors indicate no life signs, we have detected a functioning power source on board. Our hope is that their computer systems are still operational and contain information about this area. The hazard team will transport onto this vessel and retrieve any files that are still intact.
No life signs?
Like a ghost ship.
Yeah.
Boom!
While your superstitious beliefs are quite illogical, Mr. Chell, caution is recommended. Your team leader, Lieutenant Foster, will now brief you on your specific mission objectives. Lieutenant?
All right. This is an information-gathering mission. Minimal encounter probability. The hazard team will split up into two squads. Alpha Squad, my group, will beam into Control Room A. Ensign Monroe and Beta Squad will be transported to Control Room B. Our objective is to have at least one of the teams locate a functioning terminal to extract any information we can and return to Voyager. In the unlikely case of hostile encounters, the technicians should be protected at all costs to ensure retrieval of this information. Any questions?
Sounds like a cakewalk.
See the quartermaster, Oviedo, in the equipment room. Gear up, then report to transporter room one. Dismissed.
All right, that's a good spot to stop it. Obviously, you can run around the hazard team's area, go into the holodeck, do a training simulation. You know, the training simulations are basically the deathmatch maps in this. But anyway, with that, guys, I will catch you next time, and we will see what's what with the Starship Voyager. I'll see you guys then.